Hi, I am Mrs. Covington, and I'm going to walk you through parent view and student view at City High Middle. I'm the counselor for 9th and 10th grade. Ms. Ralston is the counselor for 11th and 12th, and Mrs. Colson is the counselor for 6th, 7th, and 8th. As a parent, you might have some questions. So if you don't have a parent view login and you need to create an account, you can contact our school registrar, Gina Maskell, at 819-2433 or maskellg@grps.org. In order to get the mobile app, you would just go to the GRPS link on the list of the Michigan districts. If you forgot your password and need to reset it, you're able to do that yourself if you just click on I'm a parent and forgot password. If your account has been disabled because you've typed in the wrong password more than three times, in order to re-enable it, you'll just contact Ms. Maskell again. If you have more than one child in GRPS, you can use the same parent view login for all of your children. Parent view and student view allow you and your child to monitor grades, track attendance, connect with teachers, and more. They can both be accessed from anywhere where you can access the internet. Tips from the school counseling office. We believe that parents and students should agree on how often grades will be checked. It may be helpful to develop a protocol for communication with teachers. For example, maybe the student will make the first attempt to communicate with the teacher regarding questions on grades or assignments, and the parent will follow up as necessary. And it might be helpful as well to meet with your child once a week. That way your child can develop some autonomy and understand that that's a standing appointment. And that also gives him or her the opportunity to model time management skills and then stay current on the big picture of his or her progress. In order to access the web for the first time for parent view, you go to grps.org/parent view, and you go to the bottom of the page, and there are two options, one for returning GRPS families and one for new GRPS families. So you'll click on the one that applies to you, and then you'll click on I am a parent. After that, you will click on activate account, which is circled here. And you'll follow the instructions given. So first there's a privacy statement, and then it'll ask for a last name, first name, and the activation key. You would have gotten that from Ms. Maskell. If you don't have that, you'll need to contact her. And then you will do your username and password information next. Once you're able to log in, this is what your dashboard will look like. This will be a picture of your student, and there's information over here. There are tabs over here where you can get to different information. So if you click on gradebook over here, then you will see your student's grade for all of his or her classes down here. If you want more information on a specific class, then you will click on that class from the previous screen, and then it'll show you the breakdown. So there's homework, labs, if it's a science class, classwork, projects, tests, quizzes, and then it'll give specific descriptions down below. If you're using the mobile app for Parent View, it'll look more like this. And there are links to get the app on the iTunes Store and on Google Play, but you can see the same information on there. And there's just a quote about how things are changing. So education is a multifaceted process. Gone are the days of the penned in grade reports. Here to stay are the pressures of daily life and the balancing of work and or school. A grounded and routine approach to such a balance might be the healthiest way to make our online education systems work best for our students and for ourselves. So I suppose, though, if that fails, we can always Google some alternatives. So hopefully this was helpful to you and you're able to log into Parent View. If you have any questions, you can reach out to our registrar, Ms. Maskell. Thank you.